so happy about the show coming out because I feel like we've been waiting so long for it to come out.
What was the decision process of doing their adults last time and this time you're doing teens? Why that switch?
Why the switch? Well, there's a time in our lives when we're teenagers where we're not knowing who we are, what we want to be, what we want to become, and we wanted to have a show that was a fantasy world but also a very inspirational show, and also a show that we could have teens watch a show and be excited to watch a show, and not just for adults, not just for kids. That's why there are adults and there are kids. So it's a show that crosses many age groups. It's something, there's something for everybody. And it's nice to, with all the social media stuff out there that can be very negative and damaging, there's also the positive side of social media, but a lot of kids are feeling certain ways about themselves by what they're seeing, right? And so we wanted to put something on the air with kids that were very relatable to other teenagers, where they could see themselves. Someone, you will see yourself in, even as an adult, you will see yourself in one of these kids and say, that was me, you know, or that was me. And so you see these kids grow over the time that they're on the show in a very positive way. And because there are no eliminations, they can fully develop their sense of who they are and get over certain things that maybe they thought, I'm not the popular kid, or I'm the shy kid. This throws them into a world where you can't be that shy kid anymore. You have to step up, you have to participate. So it kind of forces them into becoming a bigger, more mature, realized version of themselves. And I don't know if I'm answering your question.
No, it's a perfect answer.
It is very inspirational. And you see these kids, they don't always succeed at everything, but because there's no eliminations, the support that they get from the other contestants is really wonderful to watch. They're all there for a common purpose. There is a winner, there is a one true hero in the end, but you see them all supporting each other. And it's really amazing. And in a time when everything is so divisive and crazy, it's nice to see a group coming together. There's hope for our future with these kids. There is hope for the future. Yeah, because they all just want to do the right thing. People want to do the right thing, right? And they want to be their best self. And they find themselves in that.
Sort of on that topic, can you talk a little bit about how you found the contestants for this season? And did you have any requirements in mind? Were you looking for like a 50-50 split of male to female ratio, or were you looking for like specific diversity? It looked like a very, you know,
You have an incredibly diverse cast. I mean, we cast them because they were the best for the show.
Mm-hmm.
It did so happen that it is quite a diverse cast, and you might look at somebody and say, oh, they're this. But they're not, because they're mixed or something. It is the most diverse cast I think I've ever... even on the actor side, there's... You'll see. But they were cast from anywhere across the country. We hired a casting company. And they just found us... You know, the application went out, like, if you love the fantasy world, if you love to read books, or if you're a gamer, this is the show for you. Or if you've ever, you know, so the casting kind of said it was a fantasy show come to life. And so the kids that applied were fans of the genre and loved the fantasy world and would do cosplay or whatever, you know, or they're just an unusual... I'm going to say not unusual. They're unique kids. Super smart, super interested, whether it's theater or sports or archery. You know, it could be anything. But what we loved when we spoke to them was their story of who they are. Different kids had gone through different things in their lives. One had lost a dear coach. That was a life-changing experience in high school. They also have, like, maybe little struggles, or, you know, they're struggling in school, or they're struggling with friendships. They're not all struggling, but everybody's got their thing. I have my things every day, I have things. So it was just, like, the realness of them. We just wanted real kids in real-life situations that, you know, they're not actors, and that wanted to live in a world that was only something they dreamed of. And so that's how we found them. And they were just interesting personalities. You want to listen to them all day long. Like, you're like, tell me more. You're so interesting. Really? That happened? I can't believe you didn't get on the team right away, you know. So they're interesting. They're great kids.
So you're involved in a lot of, or you come from a background of developing challenges for reality competitions. Did you have to tone anything down considering, like, say, The Amazing Race is for adults as opposed to the younger competitors?
Tone it down. Well, it's very different than there's no bungee jumping, there's no skydiving. You know, we're in a castle. The biggest thing with the kids is that you have a limit of time to work with kids every day. It's 6 hours, which may not seem like a short amount of time, but when you're getting the cameras ready and you're lighting a room or whatever it might be, it eats up a lot of time. We definitely had to make sure things weren't too heavy or too tall. Then you have some very tall kids and kids that haven't had that growth spurt yet. So keeping things fair was very important for us. Safety was number one. The network came out and checked everything for safety and fairness. So everything was done with that in mind. We didn't really adjust the challenge we did, we probably would have done with adults anyway. There's physical, there's mental. You know, some kids are great at puzzles, some kids are great at being very dexterous with their hands and untying things or unknotting things or mentally figuring out, you know, like a room, like I gotta get there from here, what's the quickest way? Not really. There really wasn't anything too limiting. I think we weren't. It's something with animals we had to be careful. There's certain things, there's definitely guidelines, which I don't have off the top of my head, but you won't think, oh, that could have been bigger or scary. You're going to say, oh, that looked hard. These kids are strong. They're teenagers. They're not five-year-olds yet. You know, some of them are like 6 foot tall. It's like, you're 14? What? Hi. You know? Yeah, they're fully grown as far as I'm concerned. Yeah.
No doubt. The show starts with a blueprint. This is where you want to start.
Yes.
This is going to be the middle. This is going to be the end.
Yes.
Did you have to change anything as you went on? Did the scope change or the tone of the show change at all as you were filming?
Not while you're filming, because everything gets locked before you start. It is a reality show, so for fairness, you wouldn't want to like, oh, let's make this easier tomorrow. So everything, the script was written for the scripted characters. The mythology was written. The challenges were created for every episode. We have several challenges in every episode. And when I say the word challenge, I don't want you to think they're like hanging from monkey bars and, you know, like ninja. Some of the challenges are very seamless within the storyline. So something might happen where they'll see something and then all of a sudden they have to do something based on what they just saw. So that's where challenge doesn't always, it's not like they're, you know, doing a ropes course. But we didn't change anything during filming because it was laid out. And the scripted part of it, the actors, they move the storyline forward. We knew every episode, we knew what the storyline was, and we knew at the end of that episode, they're going to have to get this or do this, and then this character is going to walk in and surprise them, and this creature is going to come in and surprise them, and then everything else naturally happened. But no big, there was no like, oh my God, we have to shut down. No.
Well, that's good.
Thank goodness. Yeah, no. That's where the experience of our team comes in. You know, especially when you work outside, you don't know if it's going to rain. You don't know if it's going to be freezing cold. Is it going to be too hot? Do we need to make sure we have electrolytes and extra water? So that's where the experience of like what I've been doing for 20 plus years, that's why Disney says yes. That's why Disney gives us the budget and says yes, and the team of each of us from our film background, or reality background, scripted background, is like the dream team. I love working with our team, with our other APs, because everybody brings their expertise. Mine is not just challenge. Mine is creating reality formats, because I co-created The Amazing Race. So how do you get the story out of those moments that it's not just a competition of challenges? Where is the story? Who are these characters? And so we worked very closely with the writers, Eric and Candace, to make sure that the mythology was, we worked on that script for almost a year.
Oh, wow.
All involved from the very beginning, reading and reading and reading and revising and saying, okay, I don't think we're going to be able to do this challenge with anybody in the world. You know, like sometimes like big ideas, you want to go big because then you can pull back, but you don't want it to be like, that was, so you start big and then we whittle away to see what's manageable, what's doable, what's safe. And that's when we move forward with filming everything.
Cool.
Why was Disney Plus the right home for this show?
Disney Plus was the right place for this show is because the streaming capacity was just being launched, right? The streamer just launched. And we reach a global audience in a minute. When this gets released, you can watch this anywhere in the world on Disney Plus. And also because of the fantasy world, the mythology, it just fit. I don't know where anywhere, I don't think this... This is just the perfect fit because of all their IP, all their Disney characters. It is immersion. It's like Disneyland. You're bringing Disneyland to life. Every time you go to Disneyland, you go into a different world. And that's what this is, but it is like, I don't know if you were out there when I was on the panel. Disneyland, you probably can't walk behind and look and see 3D. In this world, you can walk around the castle, and it is a castle. You can walk into the dungeon area, and it is a dungeon. And our characters, it's like being in this room. Everything is legitimately real. Yeah.